What's up, humans, young and old? This is Sir Professor Aaron coming back to you with a new video. This time around, I decided to actually give you guys a non-vocalized version of a video for the first time since I've actually gotten this mic of mine. And this one's actually based on legs, of course, made the Aaron way. This came at the request of my eighth graders and a few of my high schoolers, who had a few struggles here and there as far as drawing the placement of legs, knowing how to sort of deal with certain stylistic choices between what type of legs they should use for their characters and all their figures. So I figured to give everyone a little dose of how I go about with creating the legs for my characters. And this time around, I'm actually going to use multiple characters from my SolForce graphic novels, because most of them are very leggy, in as much as that their types of legs, especially when it comes to the wardrobe that comes with their legs, is all very different, which leads to all types of exciting outcomes. Now, the main thing you have to really keep in mind when it comes to drawing legs is the placement of them and all the rhythmic placements and rhythmic line harmony that goes with it all, especially if you're going more gestural or more animated. And the challenge is to really get to knowing exactly how much to really put in, especially when you are going on with their wardrobe. That's why it's always best to make sure that you draw the legs going in a certain direction first before you put the wardrobe on. That way, when you can simplify it, that's when you can start to put all of the folds and the tension that goes into the movements, right? And in the is that drawing legs, especially pants, it all really comes down to knowing exactly how geometry works. I joked with a few of my students who absolutely hate math but sort of adore how math can be applied in art. I joked with them saying that, you know, honestly, if you look at most knees, they're just acute angles. And of course, the moment that they heard me say that, they couldn't believe what I even said. I think a few of them probably shot that I even brought up, you know, anything, any type of mathematics. But, you know, it's all applied, right? When it's all said and done, art and science mind, the same exact principles that are applying with drawing pants or any type of, you know, leg wear on top of legs. And the last thing I wanted to draw was kind of impromptu. I decided to draw the original versions, or say the quote unquote young versions of AC and Stephanie. These two characters you guys have seen in a few of my other videos, and their original look was really recognizable amongst my first batch of students way back in like 2014. So I decided to draw them out because I think with their type of leg wear, there was a lot of excess fabric at their knees, even in the thinner cuts. Really, it doesn't matter if it stretches out or bunches up. You just kind of have to keep in mind that AC is clearly like a slim fit guy, so it's gonna fit onto him a different way. Stephanie's a little bit more on the, you know, curvier sort of plus size kick, so it's going to be a little bit more apparent, and that's something you should probably take in or keep in mind. Obviously, you can give her a character like her looser pants if you really wanted to. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next video. Please watch the entire thing and share it if you like. Comment if you like as well. And I'll see you guys next time. Alrighty, take care.